Hi everyone, and welcome to the very first episode of Heroes and Villains, News and Spec with me, Gareth, in the Comic Cave. This will be a series of videos where I talk about what's going on in the comic world, and what issues you might have missed out on, or can still get before they skyrocket. The MCU, well, the Marvel Cinematic Universe, is currently exploding with news of potential movies and series on Disney Plus, which are driving some comic prices through the roof. We already know that She-Hulk, Wonder Man, Armor Wars, well, they're all coming to Disney, and all the speculation currently points to the next big story arc being Secret Wars. Everyone thinks Kevin Feige will announce it at this year's San Diego Comic-Con, so that's SDCC. So while DC have been struggling of late, and they won't even have a presence at SDCC 22, Warner Brothers has a discovery plan to cut out $3 billion in costs. So they usually spend around $25 million at SDCC. After all the setbacks with Amber Heard as Mira and Ezra Miller as The Flash, it looks like DC is hoping Black Adam will be their saving grace. They've even made him the new leader of the Justice League in the latest issue. I'll get into this and way more in this episode, but please remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment of what you'd like to see or hear about on the show. Okay, great. So let's start with some industry news. Did you know that Marvel has bought the IP for Planet of the Apes and Predator? So soon we'll be seeing a new run of comics from both these franchises from Marvel, along with a lot of variants. So The Boys, this is close to my heart because I love it, and it's probably the hottest show on the planet right now. It's been renewed for a fourth season. So we get to see Butcher, Little Huey, and the rest of the team go at it to take down the Supes. I've been a major fan from when I read the graphic novels, and I was blown away by the gruesome nature of these comics. I never thought a TV series would even attempt to herogasm, but eventually they did. So I can't wait to see what they do in season 4. Now, we're set to get Werewolf by Night in the MCU. It's rumored that this will be this year's Halloween special. Moon Knight actually made his first appearance in Werewolf by Night 32. So, that issue. As we saw Marvel start to push the horror angle in Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness, Marvel zombies are coming, and this ties into an idea I've had for a while, that we're going to get Legion of Monsters. So, we already have Morbius and No Blade is coming, so everything is setting up nicely for this book to do huge things. It has major spec potential, so you can still pick up this comic relatively low before it hits those ridiculous prices. Other picks to possibly jump on now would be Ghost Rider and Man-Thing. Blade's a little expensive, and so is this. But Blade has a daughter. Her name is Bloodline. Her real name is Fallon Grey, and we could see her in the MCU pretty soon. There's a 14-year-old, Milan Ray, rumored to be cast for the part already. And that's a nice and relatively easy first appearance to pick up, because it was a free comic book day comic this year, Avengers X-Men 1 2022. So you can pick them up really cheap. There was leaked promo art for Namor and Atuma this week, where it looks like Namor will be of Aztec or Mayan descent. It's an interesting concept with the green nose bar and earrings. It looks like they kept the wings on his feet. There's been a lot of hate towards the new look, but I have a strong feeling that he will soon become a new fan favorite. Another big rumor doing the rounds is that of the new She-Hulk series that's set to come out next month, and it'll introduce Ben Grimm, otherwise known as The Thing from Fantastic Four. Now that, if it's true, is big. Another bit of news from the rumor mill concerns Daredevil, Charlie Cox. Now, we heard a few weeks ago he would be making another appearance in the MCU after we saw him in the latest Spidey movie. I think it's relatively confirmed by now that he'll feature in 3 episodes of the new Echo series coming to Disney+. What's even more exciting for me though is Vincent D'Onofrio will pick up the mantle of Kingpin again, and he's supposedly in 4 episodes, running for mayor. So from what's out there so far, it looks like Daredevil is looking for Jessica Jones. So we don't know what that means. By now, I think everyone's heard that Lady Gaga is set to play Harley Quinn in Joker 2 with Joaquin Phoenix. All good, great actress. The part that concerns me was the rumor that it would be a musical. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Now, a movie I'm quite excited to see is Into the Spider-Verse. We recently found out that one of the villains in the movie will be Jonathan Ohn, or The Spot. Maybe I'll do a character spotlight for a full backstory in another episode, but as far as comics go, what you need to know is that as his first cameo as Jonathan Ohn is in Spectacular Spider-Man 94, with his first appearance in issue 97. Issue 98 would be the first full appearance of The Spot. We already know the character will be voiced by Jason Schwartzman, but due to the nature of his powers, I think he could work really well for the movie. Another Spider-Verse spec is that Madame Web will be getting her own standalone movie. Now, the Thunderbolts movie is in development and it's going to be huge. Jake Schreier is going to direct it, but the rumors are that Valentina Allegra de Fontaine is putting together a team, and from what's out there currently, the team will consist of Baron Zemo, Taskmaster, Abomination, Ghost, Yelena Belova, or White Widow, but everyone's spinning out trying to guess who else will feature. So, if you take who they're named after, that's General Thunderbolt Ross, then it's fair to assume that Red Hulk will be in it. But I've heard people talk about US Agent, Carl Mordo, Swordman, Vulture, Hellcat, Songbird, and even Bullseye. But I think the one that would make me happiest would be to see Deadpool, because he was one of the old school Thunderbolts members. So the first app of Thunderbolts is Incredible Hulk 449, which is steadily growing in price, but maybe you can still pick up a copy while priced. I think it's just going to go up. Okay, I'm going to try and squeeze in the next news stories as quickly as possible, just so you have an overview of what else has been happening in the entire geekdom before we get to the character spotlight segment of the show. Okay, so here we go. Taika Waititi wants to make a standalone Star Wars movie. So it's something that doesn't infringe on the current storyline or characters at all, but brand new characters in the Lucasverse. I think it could be interesting. Neil Patrick Harris is set to play the new Doctor Who villain. There's a new Mighty Morphin Power Rangers series coming to Netflix soon. I've seen the imagery, but the new DC anime will be about Aztec Batman. Marvel Studios has confirmed that Catherine Langford, who played Tony Stark's grown daughter in Endgame, yes, I know these scenes were cut, but they have confirmed that she'll be brought back for something. Guy Ritchie, who directed the Disney live-action Aladdin with Will Smith, he's now set to direct a live-action Hercules. Taron Egerton of Kingsman fame, so he supposedly have been in talks with Marvel to take over the role of Wolverine. Nico Santos, who I loved in Superstore and Crazy Rich Asians, has been added to the roster for Guardians of the Galaxy 3. We don't know as what role yet, but he's hilarious. A Duke Nukem movie is supposedly being made by the same creators of Cobra Kai, and rumors put John Cena in the lead role. He has the jawline. It's time to kick ass and chew bubblegum, and I'm all out of gum. And finally, Transformers 7, Rise of the Beasts is coming. The first images of Optimus Primal are out, and it looks like King Kong and Terminator had a baby. But in all seriousness, the Beast Wars series was amazing. And I'm sure this whole movie franchise going forward is going to be epic. Now, onto our character spotlight. So every episode, I'd like to do a character spotlight. So that would be info and spec around one character in either universe. So please drop a comment down below and let me know who you'd like to see. For this first episode, I'm going to do Ironheart. So for those of you that didn't know the character yet, her name is Riri Williams, and essentially she's the new Iron Man. She's a 15-year-old African-American super genius that was inspired by Tony Stark. So she reverse engineered his suit and turned it into her own. So her initial Mark I design is, the imagery has been leaked on the internet, and you can see it's rather large and clunky, but there's a reason for this. A bit of background: following her best friend and her stepfather's death by a drive-by shooting, she ends up going to MIT on a scholarship. So she doesn't have any superpowers to speak of, except for super high intelligence, some of the highest in the world. Dominique Thorne will play her in the series, and we're set to see her in the upcoming Black Panther 2 movie, that's Wakanda Forever, that drops on the 11th of November. The long-term potential for this character is huge, and I see her as being an integral part of the next generation of Avengers. She has some awesome team-ups with characters like Miss Marvel, Miles Morales, even Luna Lafayette, who I'll get into in another show. You might have heard of Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur also coming. So this is, wait, that's her first appearance in Invincible Iron Man number 7. And then her first appearance as Ironheart in Invincible Iron Man number 9. I hope you enjoyed that. Okay, so for the last segment, I'd like to do 5 comics in 5 minutes. I don't know if this is possible, but I'm going to try. And for the first episode, I'll be doing my 5 favorites, or just my 5 favorite slabs I pulled out. 3 of my favorite characters, and then 2 relatively grail books in modern times. So if you see them, grab them. Okay, so let's see if I can do this. And for my first book, coming out in 1991, this is New Mutants 98. So as you can probably see behind me, Deadpool is my all-time favorite character. Luckily enough, this issue is signed by Stan Lee, Bob McLeod, and Rob Liefeld. It's great. I will definitely do a longer piece on Deadpool, and there's lots to come. My second one is from 1983, and my second favorite character, Lobo. So this is a famous Bondage cover, but he comes from the Mega Men issue number 3. It's, again, with the anti-hero, I don't know what it is, but I really liked the fringe characters that appeared in random places. Howard the Duck, strange characters. The last one, who's just fantastic. This is the first appearance of Gambit. It's Uncanny X-Men 266, and always a solid book to get. There've been many rumors of a solo movie, but it's never really happened. I still don't think there's any downside to picking up a copy. It's going to happen. He's been a fan favorite for years, and yeah, he's Remy LeBeau. What's not to like? Okay, the two big ones, you probably guessed the first one. Hulk 181. So, this is arguably the first appearance of Wolverine. Where I say arguably because lots of people will say, no, it was in 180. And I'll even show you the panel in issue 180, where the last panel you see him very clearly. But yes, so that's one of the big boy books. And then The Punisher. So this is the first appearance of The Punisher in Amazing Spider-Man issue 129. Frank Castle, you'd have probably seen him in the Daredevil series. There are lots of rumors that he might also be back, and we hope he will. Okay, so I think, yeah, I've actually done this on time. I'll give you some more info then the next time on... Hold on one second. Ha! I've got 5 minutes. So, Kraven the Hunter. He's going to be in a new standalone movie, although it's already come out that he will play a more animal-loving character rather than the hunter that we know and fear. Here we go. So, Secret Wars. So Secret Wars is coming, and this is the first appearance of the Black Symbiote suit. Although, again, it's argued, this for me is a beautiful issue. With 1 minute left on the clock, I can say that Bad Bunny will be playing in his own standalone movie, again with Spider-Man, but his own standalone movie about El Muerto. So I might do a character spotlight piece on El Muerto, but this is his first appearance. And I was lucky enough to pick both of these. This one, A Friendly Neighborhood Spider-Man issue 6 and issue 7. I was able to pick them up for cover price. So you can have a look in your, in those dollar bins, in wherever you go look for comics. And you're more than likely be able to find these really cheap, but I see them going up in the future. So keep an eye out. There's always bargains to be had, but for me, this is a great investment vehicle and a passion, and I love it. Thanks so much for joining me. Please like and subscribe. Hit the alert button. So the next time I go live, you can watch. I will be doing some giveaways the more members I reach. But thanks for tuning in and let me know what you think. All right. Cheers, guys. Bye.